Hello everybody, in this video I'm gonna talk about different options that you have to set up your displays. By default, when you launch Music Binder Pro, a screen is created, a window is created. This window is the binder window. You can create new binder window like this and place it on external screen. But I will do another video for the external screen. For now, this menu here, you can see 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is the number of screen that I currently have. I don't have any external screen right now, so I can see that it's 1, and I have 9 screen set, 1 to 9. This means that if I connect an external screen, I will see 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, and I will have 9 screen set for 2 screens set up, and so on. So I have 9 screen set for each screen setups. By example, in my home studio, I have, I think, 4 or 5 external screens. So I have some screen set for my 2 bands. And if I only use my MacBook, without any external screen, I have some screen set only for my my own use. So the first digit here is the number of screen, and the second digit in the menu bar is the screen set number. I have some screen sets here that I already created. The second one is the binder window with a chord strip, and I have another one which is a binder window with a footer with different object, with the key of the song, the note, and the next song title. I have another one here, normal with key. It's a binder window with here a little object, which is the key of the song. I have 2 window here, the binder window and the little key window. It's a little window. In the window menu, I can see the 2 windows. If I select the screen set 3, which is the example with the footer, if I go in the window menu, I can see that I have the main binder window and multiple objects here which correspond to the footer. Okay, I'm going to the normal window, normal screen set, which is only the binder window. I have here in the window menu new object. I have many objects that I can add to my screen to configure my display. I can have title, artist name, etc., tempo, track time, remaining track time, and so on. Let's say I want to add the next song title. I have a little window here. I could place it here at the bottom, and I will go in the object inspector, and I can make it transparent, always on top, and generally, because I display it over the lyrics, I select black for the text with opacity of about 20, So, and I align it to right. And I don't want to display the next song title when the list is displayed. So I now have two little window. I can save the current screen set. So this display is saved. So if I quit Music Minder and restart Music Minder, I can load the first screen set. It will be the binder window and the next song title. If I move to another song, you can see that because the opacity, the I will move it over lyrics, because you can see that we can still read the lyrics even if there is an object over it. It's like if the object is in the background of the lyrics, because the color black and the opacity 20. If you are using dark screen with a black background, you should select the white for the text and set the opacity to 20, so it will be kind of gray, but it will seems like it if it's behind under the text. I can add other object like this. If I'm using backing track, maybe I want the remaining track time and track time like this. So if I play a song, I have the current time and the remaining track time like this. Okay. There is also a progress like this. So when you start the song, you can see the progress of the song. It can be vertical or horizontal. Place it anywhere. Let's say I want to place a chord strip under the main window. In the window menu, new object, and I could select chord strip and place a chord strip here at the bottom of the window. Like this. So you can configure for every little window. If you want more option, you select the little window and you hit Command I to bring the inspector, and you can change some settings like colors. For the chord strip, you can change the instrument. You can have ukulele, piano, you can have left-handed or right-handed for the chord strip, and so on. And be sure to remember to save your screen set when you're done. So if you quit or you go to another screen set, like this isn't a normal screen set, I come back to the first screen set, so it will load my setup for the first screen set. I could also use some objects like title, I could place a title, a big title here in the bottom of the screen, like this. So when I go to different song, I have the big title here at the bottom. I could also place it vertically like this and resize the main window like this. And the next title here at the bottom. So I have the title here. There is empty panel. Empty panel, it's if you want to, I use it in the footer here. I use some empty panel because I have some tiny bar here, but it's not a bar, it's an empty panel, gray. So I will reload the screen set. Reload. So if it's like if I have some little vertical bar here to separate the different information, this is the key, this is the master note, and this is the next song title. So you can use the empty panel to customize your display. You have here metronome. If you need a big metronome on your screen like this, you can set it to according to signature. Place it here at the bottom like this. So as you can see, you have many possibilities to configure your screen using the window new object. You can place different object on the screen and you save it to different screen set. So that's it for today.